So in this video, I'm going to talk about what is the role of keyword density in content. Okay, as we already know that we do keyword research and we use that particular keyword in our content. In this video, let me explain you what is keyword density here and what is the role of keyword density in your content. Hello friends, I'm Shivani Goyal. Welcome in WsCube Tech. So let's start with the basic definition of keyword density here. What is keyword density? So keyword density is an element of the keyword optimization that refers to the number of times a targeted keyword is used on a web page. Let's suppose if you have an article of 1000 words. In that case, the number of times you are using your targeted keyword. Let's suppose you are use it as 20 times or you are use it at 30 times. So this can be your keyword density. It is a percentage that represents how frequently the targeted keywords appear relative to the number of words on the page. If you simply multiply it by 100, in that case here you get result in percentage. And that percentage represents the frequency of the targeted keyword appears relative to the number of words. That is the 1000 words on this particular page. So relative to your number of words on the page. Okay. So keyword density is the one signal search engine can use to determine whether or not a piece of content is relevant to a particular keyword or a phrase. So this is your keyword density. Okay. Now, how we can calculate keyword density here? Just to calculate your keyword density, we have formula here. Okay, this is your keyword density here. Example, let's suppose the number of words on a web page is 1000 and the number of times the targeted keyword appear is 20, then multiply it by 100. Okay, and now the keyword density is 2% here. That is a good keyword density. By using this particular formula here, you can calculate your keyword density here. Okay, now what is the ideal keyword density here? So most SEO experts believe that an ideal keyword density is around 1 or 2%. This means that the targeted keyword appear about 1 or 2 times per 100 keyword here. Okay, let's suppose in your 100 word article, if you are using your keyword only 1 time, that is good. Or if you are using 2 times per 100 word, that is also good here. So at this rate, the keyword appears enough time to show search engines what the page is about without engaging in keyword stuffing here. Okay, now the question in your mind is, what is keyword stuffing here? So keyword stuffing is the act of repeating the same targeted keyword over and over to rank the page for the targeted search term. For example, we have one search term that is copy here. Okay. For example, now as you know that we can rank our website with the help of keyword here, and you again use this particular word repeatedly, like copy house we are doing work for. Copy, and we are also plan for weekend. So here, as you can see that in simple 2 or 3 sentence, I use this particular keyword 3 times. So this is known as your keyword stuffing here. That is intentionally when you use one particular keyword many more times so that particular content will rank on Google. Okay. So at one time, this was a popular black hat SEO technique, which is not followed by Google. These are the guidelines which are strictly banned by Google. If you use this particular activity in your website, so this can be considered as a black hat SEO tactic here. Okay. So what are the strategies for good keyword rank, for good keyword density here? So the strategies are that you have to write for the readers first, then focus on the keywords. You first focus is on what your keywords want, what the information they want to get about. Then your second focus is on your keyword. And you have to add the keyword to reach a keyword density of around 1 to 2% only. Okay. So use your keyword streaming to add variation of the targeted keyword. Keyword streaming is like keyword streaming, it refers to a search engine's ability to recognize and associate similar words. That you can say your semantic word you can use forms connected to the targeted keyword. Okay, for example, streaming of the keyword project manager could be project managers, project managing. So this type of word you can use just to make your keyword dance team. Okay, here example is just as you are using your online marketing as your primary keyword. Okay, so in the place of your online marketing, you can write internet marketing, you can write digital marketing, just to maintain your keyword density. Next, you have to use your semantic keywords to give the context and underscore the targeted keywords. Just like I give you example of online marketing here, in the same way, you can use your semantic keyword. You can use synonyms, variation, contextual text, which is related to your targeted keywords here, just to avoid your keyword stuffing. Okay, in the case of good keyword density here, you have to avoid your keyword stuffing and you have to maintain your keyword density to 1 to 2%. Okay, now the case is how to check your keyword density. So just to check your keyword density here, now you can manually check your keyword density. You can simply count the word you are using in your particular content and just divide that by the total number of words in your content by using the given formula here. Okay, with the help of this activity you can only perform if your words are limited. Let us suppose if you have an article of the 5000 words, if you are writing any content of the 5000 words and more than that, in that case that might be difficult to understand the number of the words you are using in your particular content. In that case, that might be difficult for the manually to track this activity. In that case, you can do, if your website is on WordPress, you have a tool which is known as WsCube Tech. Okay, in that WsCube plugin, you can check your keyword density with the help of the WordPress post editing page. Okay, when you simply go on your post writing page, here you can find an option of the keyword density, and here you can see your WsCube. If you are increase your keyword density, in that case there is a red mark here. It means that you have to work on it. Okay, so with the help of this particular plugin, you can check your keyword density and you can map. So this is all about your keyword density and keyword stuffing. Thank you so much for watching this video.